This?
Yes, please.
Not a trap, is it?
If it's make a baby, I'm gonna win.
Make the best music video for a nursery rhyme.
You have 1 hour, and your time starts now.
Can't think of any nursery rhymes.
You've got kids, come on. What do you sing to them?
Twinkle, twinkle, little star.
Yeah.
Hey, diddle, diddle, of course. The cat did a piddle, we used to sing at school.
Hey, diddle, diddle, the cat did a piddle. Yes. All over the kitchen floor. The little doggy laughed to see such fun, so the cat did a little bit more. Is that one?
Do you know peanut on a railroad track? Heart all a flutter. Along comes a great big train. Choo choo peanut butter.
Okay.
You okay, Joe?
Thinking, I find you really distracting.
Okay, I'm all over it.
None of us know that song, Catherine. And you know why? Because it's clearly a fever dream you want.
Richard was the only one who didn't know any nursery rhymes off the top of his head.
Why don't you know any nursery rhymes? You were born at 32, weren't you?
I was born at 6'1", but I was a normal age. I don't know. I think the stress of the task is awful, isn't it, when you open the envelope?
That's fine. It's Doc Brown next.
Precious on Doc.
Doc Brown.
Sup, kids? You know a lot of these nursery rhymes chat pure gibberish fantasy. This one's got some real talk for you, yeah? Hashtag true story. Yo, it goes 1, 2 to the 3, 4, 5. Once I caught a fish alive, I said 6, 7 to the 8, 9, 10. Then I let that little prick go again. You say,
kid, you let it go.
Motherfucker bit my finger, bro.
Which finger did it bite?
This little finger on my right.
I mean, what's your problem with fish, mate?
Not a fish, man. Not a fish, man. Not an egg, man.
I mean, it was, I should say, we filmed that, it took an hour. There was genuine, it was a mixture of blood and fake blood.
Why were you bleeding?
Well, because I punched that salmon in its face so many times. I had scales off the fish that were embedded into my actual hand.
I'm not sure it was in the spirit of the original nursery, right? But that was really good, wasn't it?
Hello. Ooh. Now there's exciting.
Ah.
It's a hat. You just don't understand fashion.
I'm ready for the party.
Make the most exotic sandwich.
You have 10 minutes to plan your exotic sandwich.
Then 10 minutes to construct it. Your time starts now.
Right.
What do you think exotic means?
That to me says maybe fillings that have never been seen in a sandwich before.
Okay. So, what I would like, please, is some Moroccan flatbread.
Turkish delight. That's very exotic.
Get me some wholemeal bread and maybe some pita bread as well. Wholemeal, though, I'm not an idiot.
So, I need a kumquat, Greg's sausage roll,
kiwi fruit.
Let's go all sweet. Heck, everyone's going to go savoury, aren't they?
Some smoked trout.
Then a crunchy bar. Then a Kit Kat. Then a double decker.
Oh, a yam. Tequila. Some tequila.
What they eat in France? Croissants.
Okay, I'll go shopping.
Okay.
Shall I come with you?
No, thank you.
Do you need money?
No.
Okay. Bag for life.
See you later.
I want to start with Mel. She looked very excited, and I'm keen to see her sandwich.
OK, she did say before she started, I want to blow the Taskmaster's tiny mind. Here we go.
This is so good. Right.
Chocolate spread.
Good layer of the chocolate orange. Little bread ski.
Double deckers.
A bit more of a Nutella. Let's go for the crunchy.
3 minutes.
3 minutes? What? Let's do some M&Ms. Maltese. I can see why people get stressed out on these cookery shows. This is absolutely appallingly stressful. Just bronzing up the marshmallows. That, to me, is like a sort of Japanese pagoda.
Can I give you this as well, Mel?
Just, yes.
To say thank you.
Is that for me?
Yes.
Thank you. Eat your exotic sandwich, fastest wins.
Final line, please, Mel. What's the task, say, Mel?
Time starts now.
OK.
Oh, gang. I've got something on my nose. What is it, mate?
Venom.
I can't do any more than that.
Stop, stop.
Those showbiz nights, eh?
Slitting M&Ms.
Only blue ones.
Only blue ones.
Is it exotic, that sandwich? It's sort of... I mean, it's instant diabetes, isn't it?
Well, I suppose so. It was Turkish delight, crunchy Kit Kat, double-decker Twix, Snickers, M&Ms, icing sugar, marshmallows, chocolate eggs, chocolate oranges, Nutella and a blowtorch. I suppose it's sort of... it's sort of exotic.
Slightly struggled with the door handle there. I wonder if that might be the task.
Big fan of tea, so this is a real boost to me. Right.
Throw a tea bag into a mug from the furthest distance.
You have exactly 1 hour. Your time starts now.
I reckon I'll be pretty good at this. Played a lot of cricket in my youth.
It's the longest part of the house. But how would I get into the mug? I mean, I'm just thinking about length. I'm not thinking about any accuracy.
What's the longest part of that?
Alex, should we see if Tim Key entered this?
Okay, here is Mr. Tim Key's attempt.
Well, I'd like a catapult. But the other thing I want is one of those things that you throw balls with if you're a dog owner. And also, sorry, can I get a tennis ball? So I worry I'm not going to be accurate over, like, the 50 metres. So what I need to do in addition is build some kind of thing with a sheet, which is like a, you know, like a cup funnel, where if the ball hits, I just have to hit the sheet and it will go into the cup. You got a tennis ball?
Yeah, there's a tennis ball in there. Thank you.
Yes!
That's incredible.
Give us some facts and figures.
It was a new world record, presumably. It was... 23 metres and 87 centimetres. It was the first row. Bombs.
This is an open and shut case. The winner of the first task tonight, Mr. Tim Key. Yeah.
Relevant?
Has he got a name?
Stuart.
Stuart. I'm not sure I'm ready for this. Get this camel through the smallest gap.
You have 10 minutes. Your time starts now.
So basically, you want me to birth Stuart?
Get this camel through the small.
I know what all the words mean, but together, I find them confusing.
Mercifully, no one did decide to, I understand, attempt to birth the camel.
OK, so this is the final attempt. Mel Gedroych and a camel.
Right. OK, brilliant. OK. Right. I think we can do it. Come on, gang. Let's do it. Red light.
2 minutes 20.
Right, I can see the high road. This is good. Shops are there. Brilliant. I've seen it. It's over there. It is tiny.
1 minute.
Okay, it's absolutely tiny. What time is it? Yes!
Here we go?
Yes, let's go back.
Well, I've got to ask the question, is there a smaller gap than Baby Gap?
Nope. Baby Gap's the smallest in the brand.
And therefore, she took the camel through the smallest gap possible.
Yes, and the security cameras will have recorded Mel Gedroych running in with a camel and running out again with a camel.
Well, I've got to say, I thought it was awesome. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to make Mel the winner. Okay. I'll tell you that right now.
A tie-break task, and this time we got them to open a jar of mayonnaise. Unfortunately, I spilt Vaseline all over the jar before they opened it, so here is the mayonnaise tie-break.
Just feel like I might need them.
Open this jar.
The jar may not leave the lab. Fastest time wins.
Your time starts now.
Am I allowed to do the task if I think I know what the task is without looking at the task?
You do whatever you want, Joe. Oh, that was quick. Yes, so with a time of 0 seconds, the winner of this episode,
Mr. Joe Lycett.
Hello, Johnny.
How are you?
Thank you for asking. No one ever asks me that.
Oh.
We're going on well.
Yeah. I feel like we've bonded.
Make the largest object properly vanish.
Largest object to properly vanish wins.
You may not use any editing trickery.
I don't know any editing trickery.
You have 1 hour. Your time starts.
There should be one more word.
It's vanished. Mate, that's so clever.
I mean, it can be. It doesn't have to be in this room, right?
Mm-hmm.
To make the largest object properly vanish, is that me? No. That sofa's bigger than me.
So let's discuss what properly vanish means.
OK.
To vanish. So it's 0 points for everyone again this time, Greg. Well, because, you know, it's not possible to make something properly vanish.
Oh, that's why we...
In your opinion.
That's why we need to discuss it in advance, Richard.
It's to vanish is to disappear suddenly and completely.
Let's just agree. It's just going to have to look like it's vanished. Otherwise, it's no points again. This is going to be the shittest series of all time. The winner's going to be Daisy because she bought a bottle of wine in. You see that show? It went on for 10 weeks. And one woman won a prize because she bought some wine in. She didn't even collect it because she was giving birth.
Final person to see is Mawan. Here we go.
Come on, Mawan.
Behold, a large animal. Now you see it. Now you still see it, but maybe you're looking at the wrong animal.
Where'd the cow go?
beyond what we were supposed to do now. Yeah.
How did he push it into the hedge in that short amount of time?
You'd already beaten Daisy by putting the duck behind her. How did he do it, though?
I'll show you how he did it. There was no camera trickery. There was some trickery, like this.
You're looking at the wrong animal.
Where'd the cow go?
The cow was never there.
That's brilliant.
I mean, come on.
Thanks. I don't usually milk things, but, you know, when you know the idea...
Hey, cow gag.
I didn't even know I was doing it.
Hello.
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 You?
Hello.
Oh, yeah.
Hello.
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 Oh, right.
Do we
strike you?
Shall I take the task from this lady? Or,
would you like to?
Yes, I suppose so, yeah. I'll take the task.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, we can so do this.
I write and perform a song about this woman.
Best song wins.
You have 5 minutes to talk to the woman.
And then 30 minutes to write her a song.
The time starts now, so we need to gather as much information as we can. Hi, so what's your name?
Rosalind.
Where are you from originally?
Southport.
What do you do for a living?
Yeah. Japanese translator.
Do you have children?
Yes, got 2 sons.
2, are they good men?
Yes, they're a bit inept at things, but that's fine.
So what do you do to pass the time?
I'm an athletics official, track judge, and I do long jump and the sprints.
Long jumper, leaping.
Who's your favourite band of all time, music-wise? Might lead us to some music.
Good idea.
Ooh, like Mozart.
Mozart?
Mozart, one of my favourite bands as well. Have you stolen much in your life?
Yeah, well, when I was about 10, I used to do a little bit of sort of sweetie shoplifting with my best friend, Elaine. I also play the cello.
Great. So, do you play the cello with anyone or on your
own? String quartet, yeah. My husband and a couple of friends.
And what's the name of your...
My husband is called Alan.
And did you ever do it in public, or was it just...?
Yeah, it's not normally when people are sitting in rows watching.
Yes.
It's just the sound.
Do you eat meat, Rosalind?
As long as it's kosher.
What's your favourite meat?
Chicken, I suppose.
Chickens.
Mm. What's your favourite film?
Oh, Hangover. Hangover 1 and 2.
Oh, favourite food?
Oh, beans on toast.
Yeah, quite right.
Can I just ask, are the other two in the string quartet, are they a couple as well?
They used to be, and then one got septicemia, so he lost the use of 3 fingers in his left hand.
Would you like to be able to fly?
No.
Bob's first 4 questions. Do we strike you? Have you ever stolen? What is your favourite meat? Would you like to be able to fly? Thankfully, he had teammates to take up the slack.
Do you want to see Mark and Nish first?
Yes, I do, please.
OK, so this, for the first time ever, is Mark and Nish's Song for a Stranger.
Hello, Great Britain.
Hello.
How are you all feeling out there?
We're all fine, thank you.
Well, now's the time that you've all been waiting for. The band!
Good evening, London! We are the Diverse Stripes. I am Jack Brown, and this is my wife's sister, Mark. This is called I'm Always Seeing You, open brackets, do cool stuff, close brackets.
Close brackets.
All right. And 1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh, yeah. I saw you translate a poem from Japanese. It looked so tricky, but you did it with ease. I saw you judging long jump at the athletics. I felt so low cause it's born, I'm just pathetic. I'm always seeing you do cool stuff. I try my best but it's never good enough. I saw you watch the Hangover DVD, but I was busy with the Hangover Part 3. I saw you listening to the Mozart Symphony, but my attention span is, hey, look at that tree.
2, 3, 4.
I'm always seeing you do cool stuff. I try my best, but it's never good enough. I wanna serve you beans on toast, but it's a fantasy, it's nothing but a boast. You come from Southport, I live miles away in Balham, and I'm a coward and I feel the wrath of Alan. I'm always seeing you do cool stuff. I try my best, but it's never good enough. good enough.
One more time.
I'm always seeing you do cool stuff. I try my best, but it's never good enough.
Something in my eye.
I mean, unbelievable, right? Who'd have thought Mark Watson was the drummer? I think you may have just shaken off the whole Heron thing.
I had no idea. No idea Nish could sing or play guitar. That was a miracle, I think.
And all that time, she just sat there, absolutely no expression on her face.
And this is the first time in an entire series where I've got nothing negative to say to you. Congratulations on your brilliant song.